It is though hip-hop began in the Bronx. It did not begin in the Bronx.
You know what I'm saying? Wasn't nobody doing nothing in the Bronx.
Those niggas didn't really even have sound systems. They had the piece together shit that I was talking about.
As the 1960s comes to a close,
hip-hop began in the Bronx.
And wasn't nobody doing nothing in the Bronx.
Hip-hop began in the Bronx.
They had the piece together shit that I was talking about.
It did not begin in the Bronx.
Bronx was, like, out of reach. You know what I'm saying? There's nobody doing that in the Bronx.
Those niggas didn't really even have sound systems.
Hip-hop began in the Bronx. Though, hip-hop began.
Those niggas didn't really even have sound systems.
Hip-hop. Hip-hop began in the Bronx. It did not begin in the Bronx.
So we are here in Brooklyn. Now I see this Founding Fathers thing they got on there. Brooklyn DJs, Flowers, Memboya, PDJ Jones. What's the deal? What's your perspective on that?
Well, first of all, I haven't seen it. I've heard bits and pieces of it. And I guess the discrepancy is that they're claiming to be the founders of hip-hop.
Right.
Specifically.
Right.
And that they try to negate the stories of Bambaataa and Herc and everybody else.
Right.
Okay, so here's the situation. First of all, Brooklyn has nothing to do with the founding of hip-hop.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
They were DJs, and I remember Flowers. I've been to Flowers' parties.
Okay.
He's a DJ,
right.
And a well-known DJ.
Right.
But him, similar to PDJ Jones,
right.
They were disco DJs.
Right.
And what people need to understand is hip-hop, or what came to be known as hip-hop, started, it was a very specific type of music.
Right.
It was very specific records.
Okay.
It was very specific type of dance, very specifically B-boys.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
And Brooklyn wasn't about that at all. Neither was Manhattan.
Mm.
Okay? Manhattan came in a little later on with Donald D and B-Fats doing their thing up in the Audubon and in the Rennie.
Okay.
Okay? So in Manhattan, they were kind of the first dudes to start playing more hip-hop type music.
Okay.
All right? But that's in the late 70s. 77, 78, 79.
Right.
All right? Brooklyn, and Brooklyn very specifically is the hustle borough.
Right.
They're like, you know how we say in hip-hop, our theme song was Apache.
Okay.
Because that was the major B-boy type of an anthem.
Right.
Well, for Brooklyn, their theme song, and anybody who party in Brooklyn, they can't deny this. Their thing is Love is the Message. Disco type of a thing.
Right.
Grandmaster Flowers was nasty in terms of disco. He could mix it, but he's a disco DJ.
Right.
All right? Later on, he may have started playing some hip-hop stuff. And in fact, my man, a kid named Aaron Reimer.
Okay.
But he's called Aaron the Baron.
Okay.
He became the MC for Grandmaster Flowers.
Okay.
And that's in the late 70s. And Aaron is from the Bronx. And Aaron himself was not Aaron and Leo. All right?
Okay.
They were not hip-hop DJs. They played more disco music. They're from Co-op City.
Mm.
Okay?
Right.
And Aaron started hanging in Brooklyn, and he became... Hi, how are you? He became the MC for Grandmaster Flowers.
Okay.
And so Flowers may have started playing some hip-hop music later on, but they're not in the beginnings.
Right.
And very clearly, like I said, their thing was disco. And that's what people understand. Even in the Bronx, you have cool DJ D and Tyrone. D and Tyrone, they played music for us that was hip-hop music.
Okay.
But they were really disco DJs. They were the only ones out of Bam, Mario, and all of them.
Uh-huh.
D and Tyrone were playing in clubs. Right. They were playing like Constellation, The New Yorker. They were playing, they were like DJ Jones.
Right.
They played disco music. And D&M, they were really like, I heard you talk about with D&M.
Right.
They were the first ones to really have real DJ equipment, like a coffin and all that kind of stuff.
Right.
And when they played B-boy music, they did that for us.
Oh.
Right? Okay. Okay. But they were really disco DJs.
But they were spades, though.
Oh, no, they're spades. No question.
They're spades.
Right. No.
So they was there. They was there.
They're there in the beginnings.
For the culture.
Yeah. They're there in the beginnings.
Right.
They're there in the beginnings.
Right.
But Brooklyn,
Right, Brooklyn. Right,
that's
right.
Not, they, you know. And so they claim him Maboya. Maboya, he's one of the earliest DJs. No lies about that.
Right.
He's one of the earliest DJs.
Right.
Okay? Flowers. One of the early. I remember Flowers playing up in the Stardust Ballroom. And the Stardust Ballroom was a disco. No hip hop.
Okay.
They did not do that. All right? That's Cool DJ Rock and the Come Off Crew, PDJ Jones, Godfather Productions. These were older people and they were not into hip hop. They did not like our music. They did not like us dancing because, you know, mostly sneaker cats. You know what I mean? So they weren't into any of that.
So you're saying they rejected the B-boys?
They rejected us. They were not into that at all. That includes Pete. Pete didn't start really playing B-boy music till like 79, 80.
Right, so later on they got into hip-hop.
Later on they got into hip-hop. But
right.
They were not into that. And I remember when Pete started playing, because it was Easter Sunday, I think 79 or 80, in the Stardust Ballroom.
Mm-hmm.
And he put on Life on Mars, and then he started putting on James Brown and Apache. And we were all in there. Me, my man Breakout, DJ Breakout.
Right.
We were all there. And we're like, yo, he never played this kind of music. And we're b-boying. We started breakdancing with shoes on in the Stardust Ballroom. And people were pissed off. They were like, he's playing that music. Da, 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 da.
And
you
know what I mean? And it's PDJ Jones.
Yes, PDJ Jones.
Okay.
He was not a hip-hop DJ until later on.
But
and that's the thing people don't understand.
Right.
We're not saying they never played it.
Right.
They did eventually.
Right.
Because they catered to the crowd. That's where the money was.
Right.
But they were not hip-hop DJs initially, and they were against it. They were adamantly against it.
Mm.
And their crowd, the people who went to their parties, they were against it. They did not like us. So remember I told you about the word hip-hop originally being a derisive term? People did not like B-boys because they felt we were coming to break up their parties. They saw us as thugs, things like that. You know, I went to parties because I would wear shoes too. You know what I mean?
Okay.
And my friends, I went to Bronx Science, so my friends who were not into that, they were into the DJ thing. And I could hustle.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I would go to those parties and I'm having shoes. And I'm not b-boying at those particular parties.
Okay.
But I was very clearly a b-boy.
Okay.
And like I said, I was with Bambada and Flash and Cool Herc parties and all that kind of wonderful stuff. And Mario.
Right.
You know, like I've always told you, Mario doesn't get the credit he deserves.
Right.
I've said that on tape. I will always say that.
Right.
But, you know, all the other discrepancies, you know.
Right. I don't want them to try to put Mario in the same box with PDJ Jones.
No. Mario played B-boy music.
Right.
He played disco stuff, too.
Right.
And when he started, I mean, he played disco music, too.
Right.
But, you know, he had Chuck City Crew.
Right.
You know, he had my man like Johnny and all them. They were B-boys. They danced.
Right.
And, you know, he played hip-hop music.
So, I mean, that's kind of foul for them to reject you at first. And then now they're sitting here trying to claim it as their own.
See, that's my thing. You know, if you were always down with it, that's fine, but you weren't.
Right.
And it wasn't just that you weren't down with it. You did not like it.
Right.
You rejected it.
Right.
You didn't play it. You made it a point to say we don't play that kind of music.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And as it became more popular, they saw the money in it or the popularity in it with Flash and everybody. Then they started playing it.
Right.
But they weren't there in the beginnings. They rejected us in the beginnings. They weren't part of the beginnings. And that's as simple as that. They could bring whatever they want to bring. I could care less.
Because
I was in Brooklyn.
Right.
So I know for a fact. They had
cats
DJ B, DJ App and Sidney B, the Grand Wizard of Sound, Grandmaster Flowers, who had the Grandmaster thing before Flash.
Right.
And Grandmaster Caz.
Right.
Okay? They got it from him.
Right.
But Flowers was not a hip-hop DJ.
Right.
And that's the part that you understand. You could claim whatever you want to claim. And that y'all were first playing DJ music, disco music, good, whatever. You can say whatever you want to say.
Right.
That's fine with me. I don't argue that.
Right.
But as far as hip-hop, that specific music and style, you were not there at the beginnings. It was a Bronx thing, strictly.
Right.
Simple as that.
Right. So, I mean, you know, they had the big equipment.
That's nice. I don't care.
Right.
The equipment ain't got nothing to do with nothing.
Right.
It's the music you were playing, the style of
the
music
style.
You were playing.
Right.
You were
right.
not playing hip-hop music. They weren't playing Apache. They weren't playing Just Begun. They weren't playing Corazon. They weren't playing that. They were playing disco music.
and actually rejected it.
Yeah, they didn't like it. Mm. They didn't want us there. Mm. But later on, let me tell you, I remember being at a party and they had a crew from Queens. Queens and Brooklyn, they run hand in hand.
Right.
And they had a crew in Queens, the Disco Twins.
Right.
Right?
Right.
They had a crew called Fantasia.
Right.
New Sounds.
Okay.
These were crews from Brooklyn and Queens.
Okay.
Right? They played disco music. Fantasia used to play for Central Commercial's parties. Central Commercial became Norman Thomas. Mm. The high school.
Okay.
Okay. They played for them. They were their house DJs. Like when they had dances, they did not play hip hop music at all. Mm. Didn't like it, didn't play it, didn't want it. And their crew, because they, you know, Central Commercial, they thought they were fly, and you know, the girls, they want to be with niggas getting money. Not that we wasn't getting money, we was getting money. Right. Not then. We hustling or whatever.
Right.
But they thought they were like a little, you know, they were like bougie. That's a good word for it. They thought they were really bourgeois, and they looked down on us, like in the Bronx, and you know, cats in the Bronx who was B-boys, and you know, that kind of thing. And so they didn't want those kind of people at their parties. And so they had DJs that played very specifically disco music, not hip hop music. Mm. You see what I mean?
Right.
And that's the part that people don't understand. They were against it. They did not like it.
Yeah, that's deep.
And they made it a point not to play it.
Mm.
So now you want to come along now because that's the popular culture.
Right.
That's the one that caught on. You want to say, oh, we was there. You're lying. It ain't happening.
Right. The thing that's bugging me out, they got Chuck D. They got Ralph McDaniels in their video. They got
Ralph McDaniels. See, now I got it. Ralph McDaniels, I get credit.
Right.
Because Ralph McDaniels was embracing some hip-hop music.
Of course, that's
video music
box. Right.
He's the first one, and you got to remember WNYE. WNYE is down here. WNYE was in Brooklyn because it's part of Brooklyn Tech. Okay. The studio for WNYE Channel 25.
Right.
That was the studio for the Board of Education.
Mm.
You see what I mean? That was the Board of Education's television studio. That was their radio studio. I did a show for them when I was 10 years old because they used to go in public. I told you, I'm a brainiac kind of kid.
Right.
You know, that just happened to embrace some thug life when I was young.
Right.
You know? But I remember doing a show for them called Let's Look at the News, where they used to go to real smart kids in public schools that was in like gifted classes, and they would be on the show. But they filmed that, or they recorded it at WNYA Studios, which was Channel 25. And that was the Board of Education's studio. That was their television station. That was their radio station.
Well, the thing I'm saying is Ralph McDaniels and them seem to be vouching for them, for Flowers and them. That's the thing.
He vouched for them as far as DJs, but they were not hip-hop DJs.
Right.
And, you know, and I respect Ralph. I met Ralph through Red Alert, you know. People know who I am. And that's cool. We're not saying they didn't DJ. What I'm saying is they were not hip-hop DJs.
Right, but they got that title, Founding Fathers.
Well, I don't know what they want to be Founding Fathers of. You know, there were DJs in the Bronx. PTJ Jones.
Right.
You know, he's an early DJ.
Right.
You know what I mean? Early MCs. KC, the Prince of Soul. Love Bug Starsky. That was the only Starsky. He was just Starsky because there was no need for him to put the Love Bug because Busy B wasn't biting on him yet.
Okay.
You see what I mean?
Okay.
So Love Bug was a disco MC. He was the MC for PTJ Jones.
Mm.
Okay? And Love Bug crossed over. Love Bug is really responsible for kind of crossing disco into hip hop, that style.
Mm.
Love Bug was really responsible for crossing that over. They say Hollywood, but even Hollywood was not a hip hop DJ.
Mm.
Hollywood is responsible for like mixing like a DJ and his own MC, like MC for himself.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because usually the DJ just played, like Peep just played music, and he had Starsky MCing. Bambada just played music. He had Biggs, and then the Soul Sonic, myself, Pepsi, Queen Kenya, and then later on, the other members who joined the Soul Sonic Force. And I also want to say rest in peace to my man, Love Hutch, MC Hutch Hutch, who was one of the original early members of the Soul Sonic Force, just passed away a couple of days ago.
Wow,
so rest in peace to my brother. He's one of my Zulu brothers.
Okay.
You know, God bless you. Rest in paradise, my brother.
Right up.
You know, Z's up to you. All right? So that's the point that I'm making with it, is that y'all were DJs. We're not denying that.
Right.
And y'all were early DJs, especially Maboya is an early DJ in Brooklyn.
Right.
No questions, no doubts about that. All right? Flowers was an early DJ in Brooklyn, right along with PTJ Jones in the Bronx and whoever they had DJing in Manhattan.
Right.
All these cats were DJing. We ain't saying you weren't DJing.
Right.
We're telling you is that you were not playing hip-hop music.
Right.
okay?
And it wasn't down for the culture.
They wasn't down for the culture. So do not make claims to the culture now that it's the one that has become the predominant culture,
right.
The one that's making industry, and people are trying to say, well, we started. You ain't had nothing to do with starting hip-hop. Not at all. Period.
Right.
Period. Right. Ain't nothing to conversate about that.
Right.
Nothing.
Word up, word up.
Nothing to talk about with it. Nothing to converse with about it. Because I don't like to use the word conversate because it's not a word. Mm. You know, my intellectual me.
Right, right,
you know,
right, right.
There's no discussion about that. You know, you're not a part of that. That is a strictly Bronx phenomenon.
Right.
Strictly.
Right.
Okay, and you know, and I'll challenge anybody on that.
Right.
I'm like me and my man DST, uh-huh. Right, say we were nomadic B-boys. We traveled everywhere.
Mm.
We traveled everywhere. We remember cats in Manhattan. I remember B-boy in Harlem in 75, 76. And they were like, what's he need? They tried to attack me because, you know, coming at me because I'm burning all their cats.
Because
they wasn't into any of that.
Mm.
They had their own style. They were more up-rocker types.
Right.
You know what I mean? But going down to the floor and what we were doing, they weren't doing that.
Mm.
You know? They weren't doing that.
Mm.
And Brooklyn definitely wasn't doing it.
Right.
Their thing is like late 70s, early 80s. That's when they started breaking. And Brooklyn started coming down to like the Latin Quarter. And you know Brooklyn, they the sticker kid types. They do
right,
that.
Right,
you know.
Right,
so
right.
They coming to the Latin Quarter, you know, Bonds Casino, when they were starting to play more hip hop music. Mm. But that's more like early 80s, late 70s, early 80s. And by that time, most of us had stopped b-boying by then.
Right.
You know, the early parts of us. That's when Rocksteady and them all come into it. The
okay.
80, 81, 82. By that time, those of us who originally b-boy, I'm talking about the twins, myself, Clark Kent, the original Zulu Kings, all of us had really stopped breaking. You know, we were older. You know, we into
okay.
chicks, we into getting money, you know, doing other things. You know, that's what happened.
Okay.
So, you know, that's it.
Thank you for clearing that up, man.
My brother, they can challenge whatever they want to. I know what I'm talking about.
Right.
You know, that's
right.
Simple as that.
Right.
You know, BX, baby, all the way around. You know, all love to Flowers. May he rest in peace to either. I know he passed away or whatever.
Right.
You know, and all love to him. Great DJ, not a hip hop DJ.
Right.
There it is.
There it is.
I think it's time that I first introduce you to Cameron Flowers, who is one of the founders of disco music. Who is one of the founders of disco music.